Hello again. During these two coming videos, we will address the topic of protection methods. In this video, we are first going to find out what are the main challenges faced by traditional protection methods due to the integration of distributed generation, such as PV systems. Then we will explain some of the various protection schemes in microgrids and determine the advantages and disadvantages of each of them. As we have seen before, having distributed generators in a microgrid results in having bidirectional current flows. In the past, overcurrent protection was implemented for unidirectional flows exclusively. The lack of coordination among the overcurrent relays and circuit breakers can result in faulty or maloperation in microgrids. In the figure, we see how connecting distributed generators on the side of the EG feeder results in a bidirectional or reverse flow through circuit breaker 3 or CB3. If a non-bidirectional relay is installed at CB3, this would cause it not to trip during faults. An additional problem caused by distributed generators in microgrids is fault tripping, where the normal current from the neighboring feeders is added to the fault current, increasing it as a result. As we can see in the figure, the fault current in CB3 is supplemented by the current from EG1 feeder, leading to the possibility of disconnection of that feeder if CB1 trips. Additionally, the difference in the level of fault current during grid-connected and islanded operation is challenging for microgrid operation. In the grid-connected mode, the level of fault current is high due to both the external grid and the distributed generators. In islanded operation, however, the distributed generators alone will contribute to the fault current, which can be much lower, making fault detection in that mode a harder task. Finally, the network configuration is also a challenge in microgrid protection. As we have seen previously, the network configuration of a microgrid may change greatly depending on the connection points of the various distributed generators, storage units, and loads. This is opposed to traditional distribution networks, where the lines are mostly operated gradually. The implementation of the protection scheme is particularly challenging in meshed or loop configurations due to the fact that current direction can easily change depending on the location of the fault. Let's now look at the voltage-based and distance-based protection methods. In the voltage-based protection method, the RMS value of the voltage of the distributed generator is measured constantly. During normal operation, the RMS value should be above 88% of the voltage rating. This condition is also called an out-of-zone fault. If the value falls below 88%, this is seen as a fault close to the distributed generator. This leads to the intervention of the control system to limit the output current of the distributed generator. The main advantage of these methods is that they are unaffected by the current value or direction in the network. However, the voltage in the network can go through several other transient incidents, such as load switching, making the voltage-based methods vulnerable to disturbances. Additionally, these methods cannot provide selective protection. Let's now look at the distance-based protection method. Distance protection relies on the use of distance relays, where the current at the fault location and the relay voltage are compared. Based on the measured values of current and voltage, the relay calculates the impedance at its location. During the fault case, when the measured or calculated impedance is lower than the set impedance, the distance relay trips the circuit breaker. Distance protection can be affected by distributed generation and loads, as the measured impedance is a function of the infeed currents. In summary, we saw that the main protection challenges in microgrids consist of maloperation or false tripping of circuit breakers due to lack of overcurrent protection coordination and change in current direction, change in the short circuit's current level between the islanded and grid-connected modes of operation, and changing network configurations. We also looked at two protection methods. The first one is the voltage-based protection method, in which any significant drop in the RMS voltage value measured results in the intervention of the control system. The second method is the distance protection method. This provides a good backup for neighboring protection devices by sensing faults in its zone. In the next video, we will go over some other protection methods in microgrids. See you there.